So, like airlines, aviation organization, and their employees were not prepared for pandemic like COVID-19. Around the world, pilots faced layoffs, pay cuts, and non-existent flight hours. It was not long ago when these developments took a serious toll on their well-being. The COVID-19 crisis exposes all flight crews, their relatives, and passengers to particularly high psychological stressors, such as increased workload due to intensive cargo operations, emergency operation, or due to crisis situations in flight operations. Jobs and security, loss of income, and potential loss of employment, long and irregular working hours, reduced risk opportunities, and potential fatigue, combined with the difficult childcare situation at home. As the aviation industry dealt with the most challenging events of its history, the companies cut their losses, perhaps not realizing how much it would affect their people. During this pandemic, we considered every aspect of economy, but we did not let our eyes on the aviation industry, that how are pilots coping with the situation and how are they dealing with their mental stresses. And that's why the way we term the safety and mental health of pilots as the crisis of aviation. In the early months of pandemic, everyone was waiting for things to return to normal. This trend has disappeared. Airlines are adding one more year to the recovery predictions, and no one is waiting for a miracle to happen. Meanwhile, the same problem persists. At the onset of the pandemic, the shortage of pilots turned into a surplus, and an army of highly qualified professionals with nothing to do. The pilots struggle to find opportunities. The situation has hardly changed. Although we feel a bit of recovery, countless pilots still have no jobs. Even more uncertainty is compounded by the fact that for many years has passed without flights. This creates a lot of pressure. Prior to the crisis, many airlines required the pilot's last flight was within the last 12 months. For the multitude of pilots since last year, even a full field of recovery would mean that there is a lot of difficulties in rehearsing due to skill decay and uncertainty over recruitment processes. Those who have been fortunate enough to occupy their jobs have likely felt the impact of industry-wide pay cuts. In some airlines, pilots reduce their salary by between 20% and 70% or more, causing conflict between trade unions and companies, which do not always end in favor of the pilots. In the initial report on the deteriorating state of mental health of pilots, the European Pilot Peer Support Initiative increased the workload as the most pressing issue due to increased cargo operations and emergency flights. With the reduction in emergency operation, the issue has been resolved, but this was replaced, at least in part, with the international shipping of the vaccine, which was onset of challenges. But the aviation accepted the situation because of nothing else but the new normal. Position pilots should be viewed in a broader context. The worldwide lockdown resulted in an unprecedented increase in misery and anxiety. Add to this, there are unique challenges for the aviation industry, and this should come as a bit of surprise. According to the report published by Life Experience and Wellness Project of the University of Dublin, in which more than half of the pilots in this study reported mild depression. Meanwhile, less than a quarter of aviation workers said they received support from their employees to manage their well-being and mental health. Some 92% said they needed this help. This is completely unsatisfactory in times of great need. Very little has been done. Nevertheless, some efforts have been made at the government level to deal with these issues. In December 2020, several countries signed a declaration for socially responsible COVID-19 recovery, which is suffering the industry the most while maintaining uncertainty and under ethical practices. But the impact of these initiatives is difficult to assess, unlike the impact of practices designed to prevent this. In April 2021, the European Cockpit Association, a major pilot labor union, began publishing the Shame of Anti-Labor Practices, which is influential in its scope and depth. A look at this list puts into perspective government efforts and shows the need to do much more. To conclude this slide, I would like to lay the stress on aviation industry. In aviation, mental health and well-being is directly tied to safety. Its deterioration due to an upheaval in the aviation sector was a major concern in the early days of depending. For example, in the first half of 2020, the US Commercial Aviation Safety team issued an unprecedented amount of warnings, as it was believed that the effects of groundings on both pilots and aircraft may lead to unprecedented increase of accident. Pilots now have been facing the challenges for a year now. It is not only a question of time when we will reap the consequences of that. It could be said that not paying attention to the mental health of the pilots, the airlines are tempting fate. Thank you.